Hello everyone, welcome to the class Soft Skills 2, whose code is KNC201. Today we are going to start with a new module, that is unit number 3 or module number 3, Motivational Skills. In unit 2, we discussed about what is conversation skills and what are social skills, how do we converse with others, how do we deal with different personalities, and how do we build relations? Okay, so now we will learn about motivational skills. You all know that motivation is required for every human being to go ahead. Some people are self-motivated, some need some push to go further. So let us discover how it is important, how motivational skills are important at a workplace, and what is its benefits. So first of all, we are going to see what we are going to discuss today. We are going to discuss meaning of motivational skills, then we'll talk about importance, and then certain sources of motivation. So let's do it one by one. First of all, why do we need motivation? See, it becomes the biggest challenge. Aajkal ke era mein organizations ke liye ek biggest channel samne aaya hai ki kaise employees se kaam karaya jaye. Har koi self-motivated nahi hota hai. So you need a push. So that is how जो motivation का level है वो totally employee oriented है, how the employee is. So if the employees are adequately motivated, मतलब वो अच्छे से motivate होंगे, तो organization को कोई नहीं रोक सकता कि वो अपने objectives, अपने goals जो उन्होंने set किए हैं, predetermined objectives को वो achieve कर सके, अगर हर employee motivated होगा. जैसे कि आप अपना एग्जाम्पल ले लीजिए, अगर हर स्टूडेंट मोटिवेटेड है तो एक फैकल्टी, एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एज एन इंस्टीट्यूट, हमें इतना पुश नहीं करना पड़ेगा जितना आप अगर खुद सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड होंगे कि आई हैव टू सबमिट ऑल द असाइनमेंट्स एट ऑन टाइम, आई हैव टू स्कोर गुड इन ऑल द सब्जेक्ट्स. सो एवरीवेयर सच प्रॉब्लम्स आर देयर. That every individual is not self-motivated. Some of them are, no doubt, but not everyone. So it becomes the challenge. So now let us understand motivation kya hota hai pehle. Motivation has been derived from a Latin word movere, which means to move. Move karna, push karna, energize hona, activate hona. Motivation itself means encouragement. Kisi ko encourage karna so that wo aage aur achche se perform kare, aur achche se kaam kare. It's a driving force that helps any individual to move further. Many a times we are made to do the same job every day. So we kind of chhod dete apni motivation kaam karne ka, that zeal, that enthusiasm. To hamare mein reduce ho jata hai. But yahi aisi jagahe hain jahan pe motivation aapko can get you going. By motivating the individual, he may be encouraged to work and bring new prospects and revenues. So it becomes very, very important for a person for achieving something, achieving certain goals, to be motivated. मैं example के तौर पे आपको समझाती हूँ. जैसे कोई factory worker है, he knows if he'll complete his work on time, he'll be rewarded with bonus or something like that, some kind of financial assistance. Maybe bonus, maybe a trip, or maybe any other kind of reward that he'll be attaining after completion of work. So therefore, he'll be very dedicated to do his work, and he'll give his 100% to complete the work, that too in stipulated time, given time. Stipulated matlab hota hai given time. So that is the role of motivation. Now let us discover some of the definitions of motivation. As per Robert Dublin, motivation is a complex set of forces. It's a kind of a force starting and keeping a person at work in an organization. Motivation refers to all the internal conditions that stir up activity and sustain activity of an individual, said by Guilford. So, you can yourself see from these definitions that it is a kind of internal force that comes, that pushes you to work hard. Maybe you want a push of somebody else. Maybe because of some incentives, some rewards, you yourself get pushed to work or sustain that activity. Now, one by one, we'll learn about the importance of motivation. Number one, cooperation and goals. How does it help to cooperate and achieving goals? अगर employees motivated होंगे तो वो एक दूसरे का cooperation भी करेंगे आगे बढ़ने के लिए, और within time वो maximum contribution अपनी तरफ से देंगे अपना goal achieve करने के लिए, and therefore at the end company का goal achieve करने के लिए. Suppose आपको एक target दिया गया है, and आपको पता है अगर आप targets achieve करते हैं वो, तो आपको इस पे इंसेंटिव्स मिलेंगे, मे बी मॉनेटरी, फाइनेंशियल और नॉन मॉनेटरी, नॉन फाइनेंशियल. सो आप मोटिवेटेड रहते हैं अलोंग विद आप अपने अपने साथियों को, अपने टीम मेंबर्स को भी मोटिवेट करते भी हैं और हेल्प आउट भी करते हैं, तो एक एनवायरमेंट ऑफ कोऑपरेशन बनता है. नेक्स्ट वन कम्स प्रोडक्टिविटी. प्रोडक्टिविटी हाउ, अगर एम्प्लॉय मोटिवेटेड रहेगा तो he will try to enhance his knowledge on the work given. वो जितना हो सकेगा knowledge gain करेगा, अपने skills को enhance करेगा, और ये enhancement of skills or knowledge will help automatically to produce the, maybe if he is into service industry, तो services को better refine करने की कोशिश करेगा. If he is into product, the company which makes some product, so he'll be more efficient for completing his task, maybe to produce, maybe to sell, or whatever task has been given to the particular person. So productivity mein definitely motivation bahut help karta hai, kyunki har task ko market ke according, changing times ke according, aapko nayi skills, naye knowledge gain karna hi padta hai. To aap agar self motivated rahenge to maybe aap bahut sare courses join karenge, maybe aap dusre logo se knowledge gain karenge, nayi nayi cheeze seekhne ki ichcha rakhenge. So that way is definitely, ultimately, आपकी productivity जो है वो increase होगी. Next comes high efficiency. ऐसा माना जाता है कि अगर employees motivated हैं और उनको कोई काम दिया जा रहा है तो उनके अंदर एक sense of belongingness होती है कि हाँ, ये काम मैं किसी और के लिए नहीं कर रही हूँ, ये काम मेरे लिए, मेरा अपना है. ठीक है, so automatically आपकी जो efficiency है काम करने के लिए वो इंक्रीज होती है. वो जितने बेटर तरीके से रिसोर्सेस को आप यूज कर सकते हो, कोई वेस्टेज नहीं करते आप रिसोर्सेस को, जितना मिनिमम रिसोर्सेस में आप मैक्सिमम आउटपुट दे सकते हैं वो कोशिश आप करते हैं, एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल हाई एफिशिएंसी. नेक्स्ट वन कम्स जॉब सेटिस्फैक्शन. हायर मोटिवेशन पेज द वे फॉर अ हायर जॉब सेटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ द एम्प्लॉय. अगर एक मोटिवेटेड एम्प्लॉय जो मोटिवेट है, जो इसको काम करने की इच्छा है अपने अंदर से, तो वो अपनी जो भी अपॉर्चुनिटीज उसको मिल रही हैं वो सेटिस्फाइड रहेगा. देखो, अगर आप सेटिस्फाइड नहीं है तो आप कभी भी वो काम उस जील और एंथुसियाज्म से नहीं करेंगे, उस इच्छा शक्ति से नहीं करेंगे जैसा वो होना चाहिए. अगर तो आप जॉब सेटिस्फाइड हैं कि आप जो काम कर रहे हैं वो बहुत अच्छा है, या फिर आपको वो अच्छा लगता है, आपको करने में इंटरेस्ट आता है, तो आप उसको पूरे के पूरे मन से काम करेंगे, आप लॉयल रहेंगे कंपनी की तरफ, कमिटेड रहेंगे, क्योंकि आप इंजॉय कर रहे हो, आप अपना काम करना इंजॉय कर रहे हो. इवेंचुअली दैट हेल्प्स इन बेटर प्रोडक्टिविटी, हाई एफिशिएंसी, एंड फाइनली this is because of the job satisfaction that you have, the contentment that you have, right? So that is the role of job satisfaction. Agar aap motivated rehte hain, motivation hoga tabhi to aap ek company mein, agar aap demotivated ho aur aapko nahi acha lag raha hai to aap chhodoge wo company, aap wo company mein further karna hi nahi chahoge. Jab aap demotivated ho, aapko aapki company hi nahi pasand, to kya aap us ichha shakti se kaam karoge, क्या उस खुशी से काम करोगे, क्या उतनी एफिशिएंसी से काम करोगे? बिल्कुल नहीं. सो दैट इज द रोल ऑफ जॉब सेटिस्फैक्शन. नेक्स्ट वन इज बेटर रिलेशंस. नंबर ऑफ कंप्लेंट्स एंड ग्रीवेंसेस रिड्यूसेस व्हेन द एम्प्लॉयज आर मोटिवेटेड. नहीं तो हमेशा क्या करते हैं, हम हमेशा क्रिप करते रहते हैं अपनी कंपनी की तरफ, उनकी पॉलिसीज की तरफ, मैनेजमेंट की तरफ. वी कीप ऑन क्रिबिंग, वी कीप ऑन ऑलवेज, वी रिमेन इन द कंप्लेंट मूड, राइट? हम हमेशा कोई ना कोई गलती निकालते रहते हैं, या हम हमेशा कंप्लेनिंग रहते हैं. सो अगर आप मोटिवेटेड हैं तो डेफिनेटली एक रिलेशनशिप बेटर एस्टैब्लिश, एक रेपो बेटर एस्टैब्लिश होती है एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की और एक इंडिविजुअल की. नेक्स्ट इज गुड इमेज. गुड इमेज, इफ द एम्प्लॉय ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर मोटिवेटेड एंड सैटिस्फाइड विद द वर्किंग एनवायरमेंट किसी भी कंपनी का, देन द इमेज ऑफ द कंपनी एज अ गुड एम्प्लॉयर बूस्ट इन द इंडस्ट्री. इसके लिए काफी सारे, अगेन वन टाइप ऑफ रिवॉर्ड इज एम्प्लॉय ऑफ द मंथ, राइट? सो दिस इज वन रिवॉर्ड फॉर विच मे बी यू वर्क हाईली एफिशियंटली एंड यू वॉन्ट टू गेट दैट रिवॉर्ड, दैट सर्टिफिकेट, that initiative, that incentive that you are getting, maybe financial, non-financial, that depends, whatever you are getting. Plus, if you are dedicated towards your work, if you are hardworking, then obviously you will be seen finally in every. So now we move on to the sources of motivation. We have done importance. So what are the sources of motivation? Number one comes initiative. What do you mean by initiative? Initiative is doing the right thing without being told. When you are self-motivated, you yourself do the things. किसी ने कुछ बोला नहीं आपको करने के लिए, आप खुद से वो करने की कोशिश करते हैं. It means going the extra mile, going beyond whatever is said, whatever is asked you to do. So अपनी normal job responsibility से कुछ ज्यादा बढ़कर आप कुछ करना चाहते हैं. That is what is called initiative. You believe in yourself that whatever I am doing, I am good, the right thing. You become your own leader. Maybe you are a guiding factor for others. Dusro ko guide bhi kar sake. But without initiative, you are just a worker at leader's position, nothing else. So by this image, it is clear that if you are initiated, this is the image that you have within. Your soul is like this, a lion. Not like a cat. So this is how it cannot be seen on your face, but yes, it can be reflected in your work. Jin projects pe aap kaam kar rahe hain, us project pe as a team aap ek valuable person honge. You can even lead them for future success. So hence, initiative is the right thing, and we should adopt it so that we can make our position somewhere in the organization. Next one is willingness to work. Students, if you are not willing to work at all, or if anyone, any employee, any candidate, any individual is not willing to work, nobody can help him. Because if he or she cannot help himself or herself, nobody can help them. So it is basically a desire. This is a wish. This is readiness. That I want to know something more. I want to acquire the knowledge. I want to gain something. I want to learn something. It means that a person does not stand in one place. Usko ek jagah pe khada hona nahi pasand. He wishes to be more qualified and update his skills with modern trends and technologies which are going on. You know that market is changing every now and then. So you have to adopt to new strategies, new skills. Maybe for targeting for job higher positions, or maybe getting the honor of the people, honor from the organization. So hence it is very important that you have willingness to work. Without that, you are just mere worker who comes daily at 9 and goes at 6. Next one is eagerness to take on work. So eagerness is ki, yes, I am ready to do this. So there is a famous saying by Chris Van Allsburg. If I'm not working on something, I'm eager to work on something because it's so gratifying. You know, this feeling is very gratifying. Gratifying means bahut satisfactory. Bahut achha sa lagta hai aapko. Jab aap kisi cheez ko kaam apne ichha shakti se aap karte hain. You have that eagerness to work. Yes, sir. Aap mujhe bataiye kya kaam karna hai, sir. So, अगर आपका इस टाइप का एटीट्यूड है तो डेफिनेटली आप लाइमलाइट में आएंगे. आप जरूर अपनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में अपने टीम लीडर्स, अपने मैनेजर्स के लाइमलाइट में आएंगे. दैट यस, दिस पर्सन इज सम वन हु ऑलवेज कम्स एंड ही इज सो ईगर टू वर्क दैट ही आस्क फॉर द वर्क, व्हाट कैन आई डू सर, अपार्ट फ्रॉम हिज नॉर्मल जॉब रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट वन, दैट इज लर्निंग एबिलिटी. See, it is very important to have this ability to survive in the market, to survive in the industry. It is increasing one's capacity to take action. Learning is both a process. A process hai, it's an outcome concerned with knowledge, skills, and insight. Right? So every now and then we have to learn something new. We are learning something new. We are gaining knowledge about something new. So, you know, there are four types of learning which we can discuss, which is first instrumental learning. Now, what is instrumental learning? Instrumental learning is how to do the job better once the basic standard of performance has been attained. Jo aapko basic task diya gaya hai, if you are able to achieve that, then you go for improving it, enhancing it. Iski betterment ke liye aap aage learn karna, seekhna, seekhne ke liye jaate hain. Next one is cognitive. It is an outcome based on enhancement of knowledge and understanding. Cognitive hai, toh it is related to mind. Mind means understanding, comprehension. Aap kisi cheez ko comprehend ya understand kar pa rahe hain. Aap kisi knowledge ko gain kar pa rahe hain. Wo learning, uska result jo nikal ke aana, wo company mein kis tarah help kar sakta hai, aapke kaam mein wo kaise help kar sakta hai, that becomes important. Next one is effective learning. Effective learning is an outcome based on the development of attitude or feelings rather than knowledge. Now, agar hum cognitive aur effective ko dekhe, toh cognitive is totally on enhancement of your knowledge. This is changing of the attitude. Kai baar attitude change karne se bhi aapka kaam karne ka tarika, aapki productivity, aapki efficiency mein bahut difference aata hai. Agar aap right approach ke saath kaam karte hain, right attitude ke saath kaam karte hain. Next one is self-reflective learning. Self-reflective learning is developing new patterns of understanding, thinking in a new way, and behaving and therefore creating new knowledge. Apne aap ko analyze karna. Main kya hoon? मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ? So you're questioning yourself that what I am and what can I do? I can be a person at this place. So आप अपने goals, aims को set करके अपने आप को push कर सकते हो कि yes, you can do better and you can do much better than this, whatever you have done. You have much more capabilities than this. Yes, you need a kind of a praise for your achievements that you have done from others. But others will notice you then only when you will show them some task. Koi end result dikhaoge aap, koi outcome dikhaoge. And that is here, that is where self-reflective learning comes in forefront. Jab tak aap apne se question karke kuch better nahin karoge, logo ke samne aoge nahin, kuch aisa kaam nahin karoge, tab tak aapko dusre notice nahin karenge. I hope it is clear. Now let us move to next one, and that is going extra mile. As the term suggests, going extra mile is that you are doing more without being asked. Kuch extra kar rahe ho. Ab jitna aapka target set kara gaya hai, usse beyond aap kuch kar rahe ho. So going extra mile is very, very important. Is type ka attitude hona logo mein, individual mein, so that they can go little further in their careers. And those who think outside the box, jo kuch hat kar sochte hain, they go to the extra mile to ensure that they do everything that they can to make out of every opportunity. Har opportunity ke se wo kuch na kuch, you know, grab karte hain, wo opportunist hote hain, jo har cheez se kuch naya seekhne ko is point of view, is thought process se guzarte hain ki हर चीज से हमें कुछ नया सीखना है. सो हेयर द फॉलोइंग आर सम ऑफ द वेज वेयर व्हिच आई हैव लिस्टेड हेयर बाय व्हिच यू कैन टर्न हेड्स. टर्न हेड्स मतलब लोगों की अटेंशन पा सकते हो एट योर वर्क प्लेस. सो दैट वन इज फर्स्ट लुक आउट फॉर एडिशनल टास्क. वॉलंटियर योर स्ट्रेंथ दैट आई कैन डू दिस ऑल्सो. टॉक टू पीपल, बिल्ड रिलेशंस, आस्क क्वेश्चंस. क्वेरी होना इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. जब हम एक छोटे बच्चे को भी पढ़ा रहे होते हैं तो या फिर स्टूडेंट्स को भी पढ़ा रहे होते हैं तो वी एक्सपेक्ट दैट यू आस्क क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम अस. इस तरह आपका जो माइंड का होराइजन है वो इंक्रीज होता है, जो आपकी लर्निंग एबिलिटी है वो और बेटर डेवलप होती है. एंड बी विलिंग, इफ अ पर्सन इज नॉट विलिंग नोबडी कैन हेल्प हिम, इफ ही कैनॉट हेल्प हिमसेल्फ नोबडी कैन हेल्प हिम. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू हैव अ सर्टन काइंड ऑफ विलिंगनेस इन यू. That is something extra that you get the motivation, but all the motivation is futile until and unless a person is not at all willing to work to perform. Next is learning and analysis. We have talked about learning new skills, updating knowledge, acquiring knowledge about the new market, new trends, new technology. We have to every time learn and do the analysis, where do we stand, right? So har learning ka analysis karna, us pe aage kaam karna is very important. Jab tak hum analysis nahi karte apna, har koi apna analysis karta hai, where I am, how to do things. So it is very important to analyze where your strength lies, what are your learning capabilities, are you going on the right track. So monitoring and seeing all this is very, very important. So I hope whatever we discussed today is helpful to you and is clear to you. We discussed about the various sources of motivation. We discussed the importance of motivation. We also discussed what motivation is with the help of some definitions. So in the next video, we'll be discussing about different techniques of motivation, how a person is motivated, and further we'll be discussing about how one can be, when can motivate others. So what are the different methods that one can motivate others. Thank you so much and enjoy your day.